I'm Rick Love for Sonoma TV and our filmmaker interview series here at the 2019 Sonoma International Film Festival. We have with us director and Jennifer Ho Kwong, who has brought a documentary feature to the festival called Art Paul of Playboy, The Man Behind the Bunny, a film about the innovation and impact of Art Paul, creator of the iconic Playboy Bunny logo, founding art director of Playboy, and the magazine's visual guru for its first 30 years. So men of my age all have some sort of Playboy story and Playboy involvement. It was the first time for me, the naked women, that's the first thing that gets you. And then the second thing that gets you are the dirty jokes, the dirty cartoons, and then maybe the written dirty jokes. But then it's the design elements of the magazine, from the bunny logo itself, that resonate, that I still recall. And it's funny, I can't remember anything about the jokes or the ladies, but I still remember the design elements, and that's Art Paul. So what brought you to this story?
Right. It's interesting, you know, people sometimes say, I read Playboy for the stories, right? That's the classical line. But back then, I think I don't regularly read the magazine, but I think they do have great stories, mm-hmm. and they do have great interviews, or they did, especially during Art's tenure. Art Paul was the founding art director of Playboy magazine. He started the magazine with Hugh Hefner together, and then he ran the magazine as the art director for the first 29 years, right? So that's the heyday of Playboy, mm-hmm. and they were a great success. So that financial success also gave the tools to Art Paul to use Playboy as his experimental ground to a lot of artistic innovations. Mm-hmm. And so that is the part that draws me to the subject of the film. And also I get to know Art Paul through his wife, Suzanne Seed. She is a writer, a still photographer, and I'm a writer. So when my book, Mulberry Child, A Memoir of China, was released, I met Suzanne at a literary event. And so through her, I get to know Art Paul. We start socializing, and I was so impressed by this great man and was full of humility. He was a great listener, you know, nurtured so many artists, but he stays off the pedestal. Like one of the artists I interviewed, he said Art Paul never fell from the pedestal. He was always down to earth. And that's the part draws me to him. I just feel he deserved to be better known.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. When he, in his tenure at Playboy, brought illustrators, graphic artists, and fine artists, and gave a lot of them a chance to make money, which they can't do a lot of times when you're in the pure fine art field.
Exactly. I think that is part of Art Paul's contribution. You know, he persuaded the Playboy to acquire the artwork from the artist. So they pay them handsomely, like acquiring, doing an acquisition. Exactly. So he was able to support so many artists. So they were able to pursue their artistic pursuit because of their contribution at Playboy was handsomely paid. Mm-hmm. And also he, as you mentioned before, you know, illustration normally is the editor give a line to an illustrator, they will do an interpretation of that line, it's very literal, right? And Art Paul changed that direction. He gave the article to the artist to say, read the article, do your interpretation, and do a painting as if it's your own work. And he used the real artwork to do illustration. So he changed so many dimensions for magazine illustration.
So prior to that, it would be the editors that would say, draw this. Here's the thing, draw this.
Right.
Which probably led to an overly literal interpretation of the content in the article.
Right. Just like Norman Rockwell for Saturday, you know, posting, right, is mm-hmm. the literary illustration. And he did everything totally differently.
Mm-hmm. Right. Fascinating. And what did Art Paul think of the naked ladies that were across from his artwork in the magazine?
You know, it's interesting. I did ask Art, right? Sometimes I said, I wish it's not Playboy, it's something else. You did this work. And he said, you know, I'm an artist. He said, I started to drawing nudity images since I was a teenager. Mm-hmm. He said nudity didn't bother me. That's human nature. And also he said violence, other things bothers me. But, you know, for human nature, for human, the beauty of, you know, people's body, it doesn't bother him. Mm-hmm. So he looked at things really from an artist's perspective, mm-hmm. right? And he also wanted to present things very delicately, elegantly. And so during his tenure, excuse me, in the, you know, first 30 years of Playboy, there are a lot of, you know, very nice presentation, and especially artwork. He didn't manage the centerfold. He does layout, cover, and then all the illustration designs, and the other part is not under him.
It's interesting because when I think about that magazine now, and my grandfather was a subscriber, it has a cosmopolitan feel to it. It was much more kind of an aspirational thing, because you'd see articles in there about cars and clothing and maybe accessories and cufflinks and watches and all of these things. And it was much more of a lifestyle magazine that I didn't realize until I got my over my head being blown off by all of the naked women in it and the dirty jokes and things, of course. Very much a cosmopolitan feel to it.
Right. I think you are very much to the point. Back in the, you know, the 30 years, that's my focus, because Art Paul, mm-hmm. you know, was the art director back then. Playboy magazine was really very much a lifestyle magazine, right? College boy, they all have an issue. The bachelor's pad, you know, people go there to see what's in fashion, how do they, you know, dress themselves, what kind of lifestyle is the most desired lifestyle. So it's really, Art Paul keeps saying their tagline on the magazine is entertainment for men, right? It's like a directory thing, a lifestyle thing for young men or professional, you know, people. So that was the focus.
So the naked photos are incidental for him thinking about it in terms of this bigger picture of a men's lifestyle magazine.
I think the nudity of women in the magazine is part of an integral part of the magazine, because that's Hugh Hefner for Sexual Revolution. You know, he came in with a mission. But Art Paul's focus is not so much on that part. I don't think he has problem with that, mm-hmm. but his attention is purely on the artistic design, graphic design, illustration part. That Art Paul, he was trained in the Bauhaus in Chicago Institute of Design. And so he came out, he was doing graphic design work, commercial designs, when Hugh Hefner came to him. To actually, when he approached him, he was 29, Hugh Hefner was 28. Mm-hmm. So they were very young. So Hugh Hefner had this vision in his mind about to start this, you know, sexy revolution lifestyle magazine. For Art Paul, he really wanted to found a venue to experiment with his creative ideas. And Hugh Hefner promised that to him. Mm-hmm. And Art, you know, I was reading and talking. I also interviewed Hugh Hefner for the film. In 2015. When Hugh Hefner approached him through the introduction of mutual friend, he was looking for an illustrator. So when he went to Art Paul's studio, he see all the artwork on the wall. He asked Art to say, is that your work or is that, you know, work you like? And Art said, both. And Hugh Hefner said, immediately I realized he is the art director I'm looking for, not the art, you know, illustrator. Mm-hmm. So it took a few months for Art Paul to agree, because he was having a successful business. He wanted to secure his financial income for his family. And so he doesn't know a new magazine, you know, would that mm-hmm. taking off, especially he came from a poor family background, and the financial security is very important for him, for his family. So he did the first three issues on a freelance basis. And then he said, to his and Hugh Hefner's pleasant surprise, the first issue without any advertising took off, mm-hmm. right? So they sold over 50,000 copies, the first issue, and immediately they know they got
the
something going.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
So Hugh Hefner, who passed away in 2017, he participated in your film. How did you go about securing him to speak on camera?
You know, I think part of the reason is because who Art Paul is, right? And he and Art Paul started the magazine together. They worked professionally very well together. They trusted each other. They learned from each other a lot. You know, Art used to say he learned editorial from Hugh Hefner. Hugh Hefner learned about design and art from him. So they supported each other. That was a very long, successful working relationship. And I understand that Hugh Hefner, in his later years, he was suffering from back pain. So he hadn't met with media or giving interviews for a couple of years. Mm-hmm. But because it is about Art Paul, he agreed to meet with us. So we went to LA to the Playboy Mansion and waited for him. And so he originally talking about giving us a 20 minutes interview. We ended up talking for 45 minutes. So that was really nice. So he really talked substantially about Art Paul and their working together. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You're a member of the faculty at DePaul University, and you've written books and made films about your experiences living in China. It's interesting that this documentary topic is one of the, Playboy magazine is one of the most American things I can possibly think of. So was that kind of part of the allure for you as well, to really look into this iconic American brand?
You know, it's interesting, when I was making the film, right, it really opened the door for me to see another aspect of American popular culture that I really didn't know anything about, mm-hmm. right? If I grew up in the US, I would be naturally exposed to it. And so I took it as a great opportunity to learn, and which I did, you know, either both from the culture perspective and from the graphic design and, you know, the art, the new Bauhaus, you know, concept. So mm-hmm. I learned a lot, which is wonderful. And now I'm considering doing another documentary film in the American popular music field, which I don't know much either. And mm-hmm. I'm diving into it right now and reading and learning. And I found this is the best way to really dig into the issue, be associated with it, and learn about it.
So well, you're going to ask questions, and you're going to be questioning it all the way through and not taking anything as a given when you're
exactly.
approaching a subject that way.
Right. And also, just like the Art Paul film, people I interviewed for the film are all the best artists, the best graphic designers, best critic. And so from their perspective, the way they address the issue just opened so many doors for me, and also took me to a deeper level in terms of understanding. And mm-hmm. I feel very fortunate to have the opportunity to work this way.
The film is Art Paul of Playboy, The Man Behind the Bunny. Director Jennifer Ho Kwong, thank you for coming and speaking with us today.
Thank you. Our film is shown on Sunday mm-hmm. Afternoon at 1:45 at the Landmark Vineyard, right?
All right.
In Andrews Hall. Hopefully we have, you know, local people to come to enjoy the film.
Absolutely. Art Paul, The Man Behind the Bunny, playing at the 2019 Sonoma International Film Festival. I'm Rick Love for Sonoma TV.